Example 3. A tank is fed with 10 liters per second of water and 1 liter per second of an aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide with a concentration of 10 grams per liter and density of 1 kilogram per liter. The tank is perfectly mixed and the solution inside of it is perfectly homogeneous. The density of the solution inside the tank is 1 kilogram per liter. The stream flow that exits the tank is 11 liters per second. The system is operating in a steady state. The dimensions of the tank and the level of the liquid inside the tank are shown in the figure below. Number 1. Calculate the concentration of sodium hydroxide in the stream flow that exits the tank. Number 2. What is the NaOH concentration inside the tank? And number 3. Calculate the mass of sodium hydroxide inside of the system. Now, for solving number 1, to find the concentration of sodium hydroxide in the stream flow that exits the tank, let's start doing the mass balance on the NaOH, which is this. Input minus output equals accumulation. Accumulation, since our system is working in steady state, accumulation is zero. So input of sodium hydroxide is equal to the output of it. For the water stream flow, we have 10 liters per second with a concentration of sodium hydroxide equals zero, while the flow of the solution of sodium hydroxide is 1 liter per second with a concentration of 10 grams per liter. Here it is, 10 grams per liter. Grams per liter. And our outlet stream is 11 liters per second with a concentration that we are going to call C3. So the inputs of sodium hydroxide are 10 liters per second of water, this stream, times its concentration of sodium hydroxide, which is zero, plus 1 liter per second of this solution, times the concentration, which is 10 grams per liter. And that's going to be equal to the output, which is going to be 11 liters per second, this is the output, times C3. From there, we can solve for C3. The concentration of sodium hydroxide at the outlet stream is 0.9091 grams per liter. Now, let's discuss what is the concentration of sodium hydroxide inside the tank. The tank is very well agitated, so whatever is inside of it is perfectly mixed. That means that if I take a sample in this area of the tank, its concentration of sodium hydroxide will be the same as in this part, and also in this part, and in any part of it. That means that the concentration in the tank is the same as the concentration at the exit, which is 0.9091. Now let's solve this part. Calculate the mass of sodium hydroxide inside of the system. What we know in this case is the concentration. So we are dealing with this case. Remember this table? Well, we'll use this equation to find the mass that is inside of the tank. Remember that we need only the volume that is occupied by our substance into the tank. So let's find the mass of NaOH inside the tank will be its concentration times the volume of the tank. Remember the volume, this is a cylinder, so it will be pi times the diameter of the tank square divided by 4, times the height of the liquid. The volume is 1.414 cubic meter. Now the mass of NOH is then the concentration times the volume. And adding the conversion factors, the final units that we are going to get are these: liters cancel with liters, cubic meters cancel with cubic meters, grams with grams, so we must get kilograms. And the answer is the mass of NOH is equal to the mass of sodium hydroxide inside of our tank is 1.29 kilograms. Now we are ready for the mass balance example in an austenian state situation in example 4.